We are asked to represent the application problem using addition in symbolic form and evaluate, and we're told to use addition even though subtraction may apply. In the first example, Shelton has $60 in his checking account and Penny has negative $90 in her checking account. So because Penny has a negative amount of dollars in her account is overdrawn. We're asked, how much do they have altogether? So the question is asking, if we combine these two amounts, what would the result be? And therefore the addition problem is 60 plus negative 90. Now looking at the sum, we should be able to recognize the negative is going to outweigh the positive, and therefore the result is going to be negative. So if we combine $60 with a loss of $90 represented by the negative 90, we still have a loss of $30, and therefore the sum is negative 30. But let's also determine this sum using the number line as well as using formal rules. To begin modeling 60 plus negative 90 on the number line, we start at 0 and move right 60 units to positive 60. From here, because we're adding negative 90, we need to move left 90 units from positive 60. Well, if we move left 60 units, we will be back at 0. Because we're moving left 90 units, we need to move left 30 more units to negative 30 on the number line, which verifies the sum is negative 30. Let's also show how to find the sum using the formal rules for adding integers. When using the formal rules, we either follow the rules for adding two integers with the same sign or two integers with different signs. And our sum has integers with different signs. So step one is to find the absolute value of both integers. The absolute value of 60 is 60. The absolute value of negative 90 is 90. Next, we subtract. It's always the larger absolute value minus the smaller absolute value, which is equal to 30. And the last step is to determine the sign of the original sum. We use the sign of the number that has the larger absolute value. So because negative 90 has the larger absolute value, the original sum is not positive 30, it's negative 30. In our second example, Kayla camped at negative 4 miles relative to sea level. She then hiked 7 miles upwards. What is her current altitude relative to sea level? The sum is negative 4 plus 7. Looking at this sum, we should be able to recognize the positive 7 will outweigh the negative 4, and therefore the sum is positive. If Kayla starts at negative 4 miles relative to the sea level and then hikes up 7 miles, she would be 3 miles above sea level. The sum is positive 3. Let's also show this on the number line. We first model negative 4 on the number line by starting at 0 and moving left 4 units to negative 4. Because we're adding positive 7 from negative 4, we move right 7 units. 4 units to the right is back at 0. We need to move 3 more units to the right to positive 3, so that we've moved 7 units to the right from negative 4. Negative 4 plus 7 is positive 3. We're using the formal rules. Again, we're adding integers with different signs. Step 1, determine the absolute value of both integers. Subtract the smaller value from the larger value. 7 minus 4 is equal to 3. Here, because positive 7 has a larger absolute value, the original sum is positive 3. Let's look at two more examples. Tom gained 8 pounds and then lost 14 pounds. What is his total change in weight relative to his original weight? So for the gain of 8 pounds, we use positive 8. For the loss of 14 pounds, we use negative 14. The sum is positive 8 plus negative 14. And again, we should be able to recognize that the sum is going to be negative because negative 14 outweighs positive 8. And if Tom gained 8 pounds and then lost 14 pounds, he's still down 6 pounds, and therefore the sum is negative 6. Using the number line, we first model positive 8 by starting at 0, moving right 8 units to positive 8. This is the gain of 8 pounds. And then for plus negative 14, we move left 14 units to show the loss of 14 pounds. So left 8 units is back to 0. we need to move 6 more units to the left to go left a total of 14 units, which brings us to negative 6 on the number line. 8 plus negative 14 equals negative 6. And again, using the formal rules, once again, we're determining the sum of integers with different signs. Step 1, determine the absolute value of both integers. Subtract, 14 minus 8 is equal to 6. But because negative 14 has a larger absolute value, the original sum is not 6, but negative 6. And for our last example, a plane descends 600 feet. 20 minutes later, it descends another 1,400 feet. What is the total change in altitude of the plane relative to its original altitude? For the descent of 600 feet, we use the integer negative 600. And for the descent of 1,400 feet, we use negative 1,400. And therefore, the sum is negative 600 plus negative 1,400. And if the plane goes down 600 feet and then down another 1,400 feet, the total descent is 2,000 feet, and therefore the sum is negative 2,000. Again, let's also show this on the number line and using formal rules. We begin by modeling negative 600 by starting at 0 and moving left 600 units, which we'll say is here. And then because we're adding negative 1,400, we need to move left 1,400 units from negative 600. So if we move left 1,400 units, this takes us to negative 2,000 on the number line, verifying the sum. And let's finish by determining the sum using formal rules. For this last sum, we are adding integers with the same sign. So in this case, we add the absolute value of the numbers. Well, the absolute value of negative 600 is 600. The absolute value of negative 1,400 is 1,400. And now we add. Again, we're adding because we're adding integers with the same sign. So the sum here is 2,000, but we keep the common sign of the original numbers because they're both negative. The original sum is not 2,000, but negative 2,000. I hope you found this helpful.